Hi, my name is Dr. Nitin. In this series, I shall discuss some of the practical aspects of echocardiography. Today, I would describe how to take the standard views for a basic echocardiogram. A complete echocardiographic study involves more than 8 different views using 2D echo, M-mode echo, pulse wave Doppler, continuous wave Doppler, color Doppler, tissue Doppler, and even 3D echo. Residents new to echocardiography should start by using 3 or 4 basic 2D imaging views. Here in this video, I'll show some of the standard views to begin with and to make you familiar with echocardiogram. You should practice on these views first so that they can be consistently and accurately acquired. Additional views, imaging planes, and advanced echocardiographic skills can be practiced subsequently. The standard views include apical 4-chamber view, parasternal long axis view, parasternal short axis view, suprasternal view, and finally subcostal view. Apical 4-chamber view can be modified into apical 2-chamber, 3-chamber, and 5-chamber views by tilting and changing the direction of the probe. The parasternal long axis view can be modified into right ventricular inflow view or right ventricular outflow view just by tilting the probe. This is an adult echo transducer probe and you can identify it by seeing S5 written near the tip of the probe. There is a marker which is called orientation marker. And it is very important to place probe on the chest of the patient according to the orientation marker. Otherwise, you may get confused between left and right sided cardiac chambers. The position of the patient is very important to obtain clear views. Most of the time, patient is placed in left lateral position, which brings the heart near to the chest wall. However, some views such as suprasternal and subcostal are obtained in supine position, whereas right parasternal view is taken in right lateral position only. I'll not be discussing about this view in present video as it has only limited uses in echocardiography. Image side interpretation becomes very easy if we follow the orientation marker properly, as I'll tell you in subsequent part of the video. The initial focus of the residents should be on cardiac chamber's structure and dimension, systolic function, and presence or absence of any pericardial effusion or masses. Next, they can learn the assessment of valves, diastolic function, and subsequently move on to examination of children for congenital cardiac diseases, which I guess is the most difficult aspect to learn in echocardiography. For apical 4-chamber view, the probe is placed near the cardiac apex, which is just medial to or at the midclavicular line in the 4th or 5th intercostal space, and the orientation marker should point towards left side of the patient. In some patients, there can be an enlargement of the heart, which will shift the cardiac apex to more lateral and inferior position. If you are not able to get a good apical 4-chamber view near midclavicular line, try to move the probe more laterally towards mid-axillary line. Somewhere in between, you will get a good apical 4-chamber view. Then for parasternal long axis view, the echo probe is placed near left sternal border in third intercostal space, and the direction of the orientation marker is towards right shoulder of the patient. And if we rotate the echo probe by 90 degrees to make the direction of marker towards left shoulder of the patient, we shall be able to see the heart in the short axis view. The short axis view is taken at 3 different levels by tilting the probe towards cardiac apex gradually. The subcostal view is obtained when we place the echo probe in subxiphoid region in midline. For a 4-chamber view from subcostal position, the direction of orientation marker should be towards left side of the patient. In the present video, I'll tell only about normal anatomical structure, which are visible in 2D mode in various views of the echocardiogram. This is apical 4-chamber view of the heart. you can see the patient is in left lateral position. The direction of the orientation marker, which is not visible in this photograph, is towards left side of the patient. In apical four chamber view, we can see, as the name suggests, all the four chambers of the heart. This is left atrium, then right atrium, this is left ventricle, and here it is right ventricle. Interatrial septum separates right and left atria, whereas this interventricular septum separates both ventricles. Between left atrium and left ventricle, there is a valve which has two leaflets and is known as mitral valve. Similarly, between right atrium and right ventricle, there is a valve which has three leaflets and is known as tricuspid valve. In this view, we comment upon the size of the chambers, functions of mitral and tricuspid valves. We should look for any defects in interatrial or interventricular septum if they are present. We can also visually assess the systolic function of left and right ventricles in this view. By tilting the probe more anteriorly, we can obtain an apical five-chamber view of the heart. Additionally, in this view, we can see the left ventricular outflow tract opening into aorta through aortic valve. We can look for presence of aortic stenosis or aortic regurgitation in this view. We can calculate the systolic pressure gradient across the aortic valve with the help of continuous wave Doppler for aortic stenosis. And with the help of color Doppler, we can see regurgitant jet towards left ventricle in cases of aortic regurgitation. This is parasternal long axis view of the heart. You can see patient is in left lateral position. The probe is placed in third intercostal space. And the direction of the orientation marker is towards right shoulder of the patient. In parasternal long axis view, we can see left atrium, left ventricle, right ventricle, and the aortic root. This is mitral valve between left atrium and left ventricle. We can see the aortic valve and interventricular septum between left and right ventricles. In this view, we can comment on the size of left atrium, proximal aorta, functions of mitral and aortic valves. With the help of M-mode, we can also calculate the LV ejection fraction quantitatively in this view. By changing the direction of the probe towards left shoulder of the patient, we get a short axis view of the heart. You can see that probe is in the same third intercostal space, just lateral to the left external border. But now the orientation marker points towards the left shoulder of the patient, and the patient is in left lateral position as before. As I discussed earlier, that short axis view is obtained at three different levels of left ventricle. This is aortic valve level, other two are papillary muscle level and mitral valve level. In this view, we can see the left atrium, interatrial septum, right atrium, tricuspid valve, right ventricular outflow tract, pulmonary valve, main pulmonary artery, and by tilting the probe little bit, you can see main pulmonary artery dividing into right and left pulmonary arteries. You can also see the left atrial appendage with some manipulation in the probe in this view. And in the center of the image, we can see aortic valve. This is the most commonly used view to see the function of pulmonary valve. With color Doppler, you can see pulmonary regurgitation if present. With continuous wave Doppler, you can measure the gradient at pulmonary valve in cases of pulmonary stenosis to quantify its severity. This is the only view in which you shall be able to see all the three cusps of aortic valve. If only two cusps are present, then it is known as a bicuspid aortic valve. This is same short axis view of the heart but at papillary muscle level. It is obtained if you tilt the probe towards cardiac apex from the previous position. In this view, you can see both the papillary muscles of left ventricle. This is anterior lateral papillary muscle and this is posterior medial papillary muscle. With visual assessment, you can also comment on the left ventricular function in this view. If you tilt the probe further towards the apex, you will be able to get the short axis view of the heart at the level of mitral valves. In this view, you can see both the leaflets of mitral valve clearly. This is anterior mitral leaflet and this is posterior mitral leaflet. If mitral valve is stenosed, you can calculate the area of mitral valve opening in this view. For suprasternal view, the transducer probe is placed in suprasternal area, just above the superior margin of the manubrium sterni. The orientation marker points superiorly and the patient lies supine. In this view, you can see the ascending aorta, arch of aorta, and descending aorta. You will be able to see coarctation of aorta in this view if it is present. Other than this, you can also see the vessels arising from the arch of aorta, which are right innominate artery, left common carotid artery, and left subclavian artery. For the subcostal view, the transducer probe is placed in subxiphoid region, just below the lower part of sternum, and is tilted anteriorly to focus on the heart. The patient will lie supine for this view. To obtain a four-chamber view, tilt the probe anteriorly until you are able to focus on the heart and keep the orientation marker towards left side of the patient for easy identification of cardiac chambers. In this view, you will be able to see left atrium, interatrial septum, right atrium, left ventricle, interventricular septum, right ventricle. You can also see the two atrioventricular valves, which are mitral and tricuspid valves. As I told earlier, mitral valve is located between left atrium and left ventricle, whereas tricuspid valve is located between right atrium and right ventricle. Thank you for watching this video. If you want to learn more, please subscribe to this channel. Thank you for your support.